Friday night football in Texas. Nothing's better than that, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
It's all about controlled violence. Controlled violence. Football game.
And that is a tremendous play from Daniel Luna as he was fighting off the block of Adrian Anderson while bringing the big quarterback down.
Last week it was all about stopping the pass. It's the opposite tonight.
O-line, D-line, take over the football game. Mm-hmm. You're going to win the game tonight in the trenches.
The entire defensive line for Everman, they were all on the ground.
Playmakers, go make play.
Renfro will throw out on the far side. Caught. Breaks away. That's Morrison. Across the 50. 45, 40. Inside the 35. Inside the 30. Breaks a tackle. Inside the 20. Down to the 15-yard line. Trace Morrison with the opening field goal on the opening drive for the Jackets, and they take the lead.
Great read from Austin that time, just shooting in.
Renfro again in the pistol, and again the give, and in some trouble in the backfield. But breaking tackles is Phillips, and he's got the sideline. Inside the 40, down the 35 to the 34-yard line. Hey, we're going to try a 50-plusser right here. Aiken the hole. Morrison with plenty of boot on this one, and it is good from 50 yards. Trace Morrison puts another field goal on the board, and the Jacket lead extends. It's now 6-0 Stephenville. Bulldogs of Everman nothing. Gives it to that man, the same type of play, but the other direction. Colton Nakamazo there for the stop at the line of scrimmage. Twins far side, play action. Tate stepping up, throwing across the middle, and it's picked off. Coming to the near side, that's Roundtree across the 30. Looking, coming to the near side, rotating around. Renfro escapes the pressure on the far side, looks to throw. Deep, has an open receiver, it's caught. Trewick behind the defense, breaks a tackle across the 50, inside the 45, down the 40 to the 38-yard line.
The Bulldogs outside the 10.
Again the give. Dave Mills gets the first down. Inside keeps pushing, and it's a touchdown. The freshman runs over about three Jackets and gets into the end zone, and we're tied at 6. Extra point upcoming.
But may have fumbled the ball we were talking about there.
Yeah, we've just got a report from some of the cameramen that follow us around. Hey, Chris, what's going on? And down on the sideline, they noticed that Mills fumbled the ball at the 1 before going in. Stephenville recovered the ball in the end zone, but the line judge out on the Everman side had already whistled a touchdown. So a tough break there, but nonetheless, that happens in this sport, and we don't have instant replay.
Renfro looks to go on the screen on the near side, and a catch is made in big running room. Phillips with a shake and bake across the 40, the 45, keeps his feet turning all the way to the 49-yard line.
Out of the game, Norton in it, running back instead, throwing this across the middle. It's picked off. Trace Morrison down the sideline. 40, inside the 35, the cutback, and he's down at the 31-yard line. Everman has taken a lot of clock here in the third quarter.
This is one thing the Bulldogs were hoping to do, is use their size and just wear down Stephenville, especially with so many players going both ways. And late here in the Texas Bank third quarter, that's exactly what Everman is doing.
Giving on the left side and blown up in the backfield. It's a loss of a yard at least.
play action throw on the right side, cutting away. That's Trawick into the open field, across the 40, down to the 38-yard line.
That was a great throw from Cade. He came in, didn't think, just zipped it right into Grayson and gets it all the way into Everman territory.
This is a loss of 3 to 4 yards on Hill. And so for the Jackets, getting there on top of it was John Rex Hale with the stop. Renfro looking. Now we'll throw this one on the side. It's caught out of bounds as Morrison. Throwing on the flats. Caught by Roundtree. Slips by. Has a first down. Inside the 30, the 25. Inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. Play action here. Now Renfro steps up, throws into the far fade. It's up, and it's caught. Touchdown, Stephenville. Grayson Trawick, and the Jackets have their first touchdown of the game, and it gives the Jackets a 12-10 lead.
Cade Renfro made one of the best throws he has made since he's been the quarterback over the last couple of years.
A new score, Stephenville 13, Everman 10. He will hand off on the right side. That may be Mills. Sidesteps a tackler, jumps over the top into the secondary, inside the 10, inside the 5, down to the 4, to the 3-yard line. Play action. Davis looking, stepping inside, and Austin Stidham with a big hit, throws it, and it's picked off. Coming to the near side, down the sideline, the 30, the 35, out to the 40, and the Jackets have taken it. The big defensive play as Stidham put the hit on Davis. He tried to throw it away, and it was picked off by Roundtree on the far sideline. And the Jacket defense may have pulled this one out of the fire. The knee is there, and your Jackets will go to 1-1 on the year. And it is a happy Jacket crew on the sideline. Congratulations to Sterling Doty as he gets his first victory as a head coach of the Stephenville Yellowjackets.
The Varsity Moms and the Stephenville Yellowjackets are so thankful for our amazing video sponsors. These videos will stay with these boys in our community for years to come. Thanks to The Purple Goat, Heartache Barbecue, S-Dub Fitness, Stanley Hay, Cowan Ag Solutions, Cross Timbers Orthopedics, Priority Electrical Contracting, First Financial Bank, Signs Express, BC Insurance, Jesse's Air, Bramlett Implement, and JJ Hampton Realty.